study. The basic contents of the study. This is the basic contents. The study involves two parts. The first part is the advantages of newspaper reading. And the second part is college challenges of newspaper reading. In the first part, we will analyze advantages of newspaper reading through two perspectives. The first perspective is subjectively, and the second perspective is from objective aspects. And the second part, we will discuss the challenges of newspaper reading from the teacher's point of view and from the student's point of view. And let's move on to each part in details. The advantages of newspaper reading, first of all, objectively. Objectively speaking, language in newspapers are carefully selected and organized by native speakers. Qualified newspaper language. We see we always learn English in our textbooks, but where the articles in the textbooks from? Most of them from official papers. So we can recommend those papers to students and let them select the interesting contents by themselves. That is the second point. Newspapers contain various topics. In a newspaper, you can find political news, you can find economical news, and sports, movies, literature, even advertisements. Students can select the content they are interested in. That is the key to learning a foreign language, that's interest. So various topics are very important for foreign language learners. And the third point is that convenience of internet makes electronic reading possible and popular. Nowadays, it is not like the old days. We can use the internet to make electric reading. This kind of reading pattern will allow you to find more articles. Instead of a heavy book, you can see New York Times, you can see Times, you can see Observers on the internet through several minutes. So this is the objective reason for reading a newspaper as a foreign language acquisition method. And this page we can see the subjective reasons for the newspaper reading. Students are allowed to actively select the interesting learning materials according to the levels of language skills. In the same class, in the same group, students are at different levels. Some of them are very good at English, but others are not. So they can select the interesting learning materials according to their own abilities. That is very valuable. And the second point is that students can encounter and maybe develop a different thinking pattern with reading foreign newspapers. Newspapers, more or less, stand for the attitude for the government. Different governments have different attitude towards the same event. So through reading different newspapers, students may encounter different thinking patterns as different cultures. And the third part is that students can learn how to collect, process information, in a proper way. In a newspaper, the article is very logical, it's very reasonable, rational. So a student can learn how to collect, how to process information in a very official way. That is the third subjective reason for reading newspaper as a second language learning material. Also, there is some challenges of newspaper reading. For teachers, there are a lot of challenges because this is a very new teaching method for most of the second language teachers. So they should have ability to make clear the student-centered pattern and to help students learn independently. We have been used to teaching students the materials instead of teaching them the learning methods. But it is time to change our thinking pattern. Students at the center of the classroom, what we should teach them is the learning materials and the learning strategies rather than the specific vocabulary or grammatical rules. And the second point is the teacher should be able to make use of limited qualified class hours and to arrange effective assignments. Again, do not push the specific vocabulary, the specific words. Instead, to put them some strategies and leave them some assignments effectively. And the third point to mention is that the students should be able to select appropriate reading materials. That is very important because although teachers is not the center of the classroom, but students need their help. They cannot all select reading material by themselves. Teacher should select in advance. The challenges for students also include three points. The first is to develop newspapers reading as a learning habit. Most of the students, especially a foreign language learner, do not have the habit to read newspaper. So in order to develop newspaper reading as a learning habit, the curriculum is very helpful. The second point is to learn a foreign language independently. By learning independently, you need to identify your own interest. You should use the teacher's guide as a guideline instead of all the learning materials. You should find your own way to learn the foreign language. And the third part is to use the known vocabulary and grammar in practice. Although some of the students may have very large vocabulary and have known a lot of grammatical rules, but they do not apply them in daily life. That is a pity. So, by newspaper reading, you can use this known vocabulary and grammar in practice. So, here comes the conclusion. As an approach of foreign language acquisition, newspaper reading has its advantages and challenges for both independent students and foreign language teachers, and it can be adopted in a curriculum at higher educational level. There have been some existing examples of special foreign newspaper reading class in some universities. For example, in Peking universities, there is such kind of class. But it is highly recommended to expand the scope of this kind of class because all in all, newspaper reading is a very effective approach of foreign language acquisition. So that is all my presentation. Thank you very much. You can contact me by this email. Thank you very much.